Hey guys, Lucas here, and welcome back to the channel. So recently we shared some of our top tips on keeping kids secure on the internet, and thanks everyone for all your welcome feedback on that, by the way. And since then we've had a lot of requests for how to keep smartphones secure. Now, technology has come a long way, and having a smartphone is like walking around with a miniature computer in your pocket. But the more you do on your phone, the more your security is at risk. So if you're watching this video, that's a step in the right direction, and we're going to share with you some of our top tips for keeping your information right where it needs to be, safe and secure, locked up tight in your phone, even if you lose it. And since our channel makes your cybersecurity our top priority, as always, we'll also include any helpful links to anything we talk about down in the description area below, so be sure to check that out. Now, first and foremost, since most of us use our phones for nearly everything these days, it makes them incredibly vulnerable to attack. And if you use public Wi-Fi networks, you're even more vulnerable. So one of the best and first things you should do is use a password manager. Password managers allow you to pick good, strong passwords with different combinations that are hard to guess. And you don't have to memorize them because the password manager does the remembering for you. And I don't know about you, but I can use all the help I can get in that department. Like, where did I even leave my keys this morning? So, not to mention, these password managers make it more difficult for you to be a victim of a cyber attack by storing your passwords in an encrypted vault, meaning if a so-called hacker is attempting to view your password, they simply won't be able to read it. 1Password, Bitwarden, or LastPass are all good, highly rated options to choose from, ranging from free to just a few dollars per month, depending on the plan you select. Additionally, most phones come with a lock screen that you can set up with fingerprint and facial recognition, or at the very least, you can use a PIN code. But that being said, it would be better to use a fingerprint or facial recognition. The odds of a stranger just randomly picking up your phone and managing to fool the facial recognition software is about 1 in a million, whereas guessing your PIN is about 1 in 50. So I think the odds are a pretty good argument in favor of using facial recognition software. Now, the next tip is a two-factor authentication, which you can set up with facial recognition or fingerprint. So in case you lose your phone and someone somehow gets past your lock screen, they won't have access to any of your accounts if you utilize two-factor authentication, which is most common with banking apps and other higher security apps. And speaking of high security, it is important to know that when using these apps, you're only secure while actually using them, not while logging into them. So how do you stay private and secure while your data is in transit? The best way is by using a virtual private network, or VPN. A VPN works by doing two things very well. It encrypts all your data or scrambles it by making it unreadable, and it also hides your location or IP address by connecting you to a proxy server. It's just an added layer of security that works together with strong passwords and antivirus protection while you're using the internet so that cyber criminals can't read your information while you're online. There are some good ones to choose from, and if you've been around this channel for any amount of time at all, you already know a lot of the free ones come with malware and spyware, or might even sell your information to third parties, so we don't normally recommend you going that route. By the way, one of the best VPNs you can get is Nordvpn, which is my personal favorite to use. I use it all the time, and I will leave a link to that down in the description area below. I talk more about Nord in my favorite cybersecurity products video, which I will leave a link to that below as well, if you'd like to check that out. In that video, I go through all of our top recommendations for protecting your privacy and keeping your family safe online, which includes why VPNs are great to use and some of the main reasons that I use this one in particular. Now, another tip is we wouldn't normally think about how keeping our smartphones up to date can affect the security of the device, but most smartphones come with antivirus protection and security features installed. And if your phone is outdated, those security features are outdated too. And I know, it's super inconvenient to have to wait for the updates and to restart your phone, and it needs to do its thing, and it can be a minor headache. So what you can do to avoid this is set it to automatically update for a time when you'll be sleeping. I mean, we all have to sleep at some time, so might as well let it update while you're sleeping. And sometimes, depending on the device, it can take up to an hour or so, so make sure you set it early enough. That way, your phone will be finished by the time your alarm needs to go off in the morning, or you may end up missing out on the coffee morning before work, which you'd never want to have to do that. Also, as I mentioned before, we do everything on our phones these days, which requires downloading apps. Now, when downloading apps, it is essential to make sure that they're legitimate, meaning that they're the real deal and actually what you're looking for, not to mention that they're reputable. Plus, you're going to want to check out the app permissions as well. You'd be surprised what some apps sneak into their permissions, like using video, audio, and location. The App Store is one of the most common sources for phone malware and viruses, so keep this in mind and use extreme caution when downloading apps and accepting app permissions. In the past, there have been some apps that could even turn on the camera and take video without the user's knowledge. So that's pretty scary to think about and a good reason to read those app permissions before you accept them. Well, that wraps up our tips for how to keep your smartphone private and secure. So being smart and well-informed is always the best thing you can do to keep your information secure in today's technological world. Hopefully these tips have been helpful, so be sure to let us know down in the comments. And if you'd like to learn more about my favorite cybersecurity products, I'll leave a link to the video of that down below as well. And as I mentioned earlier, this includes all of the most essential online security products that the average person would benefit from the most for protecting their family's privacy and staying safe online. Also, if you have any questions about cybersecurity or VPNs, we're always happy to help with those. And if there's any other video topics that you think we should address, please let us know about those as well down in the comments. We always love to hear from you. Otherwise, guys, thanks so much for watching. Welcome to the community. Thanks for being one of our cyber friends, and I will see you in the next video.